Hello darlings, welcome back to my channel. If you don't know me, my name is Tess and I am a rainbow witchy creative mess. Now today I've actually got a vlog for you, and I could be wrong, but it feels like forever since I have actually vlogged, so let's do that. Also, sorry there's been such a big gap between my last video and now. Like, I've had so much going on. So I've got a few things that need doing. I haven't got any students today, which is good because I want to do some cleaning up. And by cleaning up, I mean picking up most of the stuff around the house that is mine, because obviously there's, you know, a glass over there that my mother probably used, but you know, Mum doesn't have Francois, and so his bowl needs cleaning, and that's not her problem. So I need to do some of that. Probably gonna be a boring day full of errands and chores. But first of all, I need to haul my ass into Chatswood, which is near where I live. It's a suburb of Sydney. Because I need a new internet dongle thingy, because the internet on my laptop rather stopped working, which is another reason why I wasn't uploading videos, because I couldn't. Okay, OOTD, my midsummer shirt from Redbubble and my black milk shorts that are technically Halloween because they've got the jack-o'-lanterns on them, but I just wear them all the time and I don't care. So yep, here we are. So I'm back home now, and you will never guess what. A Mac One of the Wi-Fi adapter did not exist at that store. And so then I was Googling and Googling, and I was getting ready to like punch a hole in a wall, when finally I found something that is universally compatible. It was only available that I could see on Amazon, and I just have a permanent hatred of Amazon because Jeff Bezos can just... So I had to swallow my pride this one time. Oh, so yesterday, Mom came home with the newspapers, and she just dumps this like piece of the newspaper, one of the, you know, booklets of it, just in front of me. And then I saw it was this. Francois is keeping an eye on Austin. There have been so many television appearances, and now I guess this photo, where I think he just forgets that buttons exist. Honestly, I didn't think anything could equal my Timmy Chalamet crush, but this blonde idiot has just come yeeting himself into my mind when Elvis came out, and I was fully expecting him, when I saw the movie, to be, you know, useless pretty boy, but he was incredibly talented, and that's part of the reason why it makes me so mad. And him and Timmy, my other equal crush, are now in the same movie, and their characters beat the shit out of each other. So, I have to show you this pink galah tea towel before we keep going on. But speaking of cute boys, I want to apologize for who I am going to become when the Outsiders Broadway musical comes out, which is very close, because you guys know I love the book, I love the movie, and I particularly love Johnny. He is the like character out of every fictional universe that I am the most protective of. Like, it's literally only him is how I feel that strongly about. And so I'm very excited to hear his song. A girl I know from school who lives in the States saw a version of the musical earlier and she said it made her cry despite never seeing the book or movie. So obviously I and other people who are fans already are going to be completely destroyed. So, okay guys, so I finished tidying the kitchen. I'm gonna see if I have more energy to do any more physical cleaning. Out here, just tidying up some of my stuff, aka all the stuff. But I do not think I will have the energy to tidy my room or my bathroom today because they both need it and I can already feel my energy fading. So what I think I'm gonna do right now, and then maybe I will clean after if I can be bothered, is finish labeling all of my hard drives because they've all got names and they're all covered in stickers to tell them apart. So I've been bringing them out here and looking at everything that's on them and noting it all down on a document. Like other people, you know, filmmakers or whoever, like they just number them, I'm sure. Whereas for me, it's like opportunity to decorate is upon us. And now I would like to present to you my mess of crap on the coffee table. Now this is a bag that I used the other day. I don't know if you've ever seen me with this bag. As you can see, it is printed to be a Birkin bag from Hermes. Next most exciting thing, Christmas present from my dear baby Luca, who you guys have met a bunch of times. He is interested in Norse paganism, so he got me this. Next, mermaid reusable cup. I don't even want to think about what's in here. I bought a big bag of Easter eggs because tis the season, little solid Easter eggs, you know, it begins. And so obviously I split the bag between a bowl for me and a bowl for mum. And I have already eaten all of my eggs because I am who I am. But mum wants hers to last and so she has a special trick that she has played. So this is one of our antique cupboards. There's the cupboard. And she has put her Easter egg bowl in here so that like it's away, it's out of reach and it's out of sight, because obviously if something is in sight you're gonna eat more of it. So instead she is a friggin genius who has just hidden hers away in here, and I obviously did not, and that's why I've eaten all of mine. So yep, reason number 100 million why this woman is smarter than me. Yep. This is gonna be like the 500th millionth time that I've mentioned Newsies on my channel. Like I made a fan edit of it and that's not even been enough. But like I finally showed it to my dear friends, Laura and Luca the other day. And Luca is very much a unionist. So he was like enjoying it and getting really passionate and it was really cool. And I knew that he would like it for that reason. But then at the part where it looks like Jack has accepted Pulitzer's money and you know, everything turns to shit and it looks like he's betrayed them all, Luca took it so seriously, because then after that when him and Catherine are having their little cute song, Luca was like, "Don't go with him, he's a scab," and I was like, oh my god, this is a friggin' like Disney show where everything's gonna turn out fine. But oh my god, I just, that is why I love my friends. Like they're so passionate about the things that they care about to the point that like in that situation they're just going, you know, nope, scab, worthless. And honestly, like Jack is a scab at that point, but it's just, it's so funny that I don't even think of it that way when it's me. But Luca's just like, yep, that's what he is. We're going all in. I'm no mercy. All right, so I have done the kitchen. I've done the coffee table. and I've changed Francois's water. I'm gonna keep writing a story that I've been experimenting with lately. I think you guys have heard me complain 500 million times that I've had writer's block for so long, and it just felt like whenever I wrote, no matter what it was, someone else was in my brain trying to do it. And now, for some reason, writing this particular story that is completely off my brand. Like, I don't want to tell you guys anything about it because that makes me feel strange, but like, it is so different than the things I normally write. I can't say this without sounding like a terrible person, but it's so much more mainstream than what I usually do. This is where we are. Okay, sweetie darlings, good morning and welcome back to this vlog. Or is it good afternoon by now? I don't know, can't remember. I slept in a little bit because I don't know if you can tell by my voice, but I am getting sick as... And that's great, love that for me, just what I need. Basically all it is at this point is, every so often I'm just coughing and it sounds like smoker's cough, so, you know, that's just lovely. I want to dye something. I am in the midst of, putting together an, 1960s style outfit using, hand-me-downs and thrift and DIY. So I have found, something that I want to use for that outfit, and putting this whole thing together is going to be its own video. But I'm just telling you now because that's what I'm going to be doing for a second. But basically I found white shorts. I wanted a skirt, but I just, why did I say it like that? Skirt. But I just couldn't find one, and so I gave up and got some shorts from a thrift store. But they are white, and so obviously me being me, I need to dye them bright purple. So that's where we are. I'm gonna get organized to do that, and I'll see you in a bit. See what I said about the pop? See what I said? Alright, lordy me, I took the pot off the thing, and obviously I needed two hands, so that's why I'm showing you now. And now I've been running cold water over this. I'm interrupting my rinsing of the dye to tell you this story because it suddenly occurred to me and I am terrified that I'm going to forget to tell you because it was so amazing. I was out last week. I was just walking and there was this couple, would you call them elderly? I'm not sure, late 60s, early 70s, husband and wife that were next to me because we were about to cross the same road. And this woman had a really beautiful zebra brooch on her shirt, and so me being me, as I always do, being a brooch addict myself, as you guys know, I literally make them. I'll link the video of how I make them down below. I just had to go up to her and to say, oh my god, that is an absolutely beautiful brooch. And do you know what she did? She plucked it off her shirt and gave it to me. Literally just... within 30 seconds of meeting me, she just, yep, there you go. I do not have anything in this style or indeed as a zebra. Like, can you friggin' believe that this woman was just like, yoink, here you go. She just yeeted it at me. Can you believe that? Like, I just... That was amazing. Now that woman just blew my head off with her kindness, and I love her, and I can't even remember her name, but I wanted to show you Mr. Zebra and put that woman's like radical compassion and kindness on film by telling you the story, because man oh man, do we need some radical compassion right now in this world. Just aggressive kindness, bro. Woo! Okay, so I finally finished rinsing the shorts. The instructions are now to wash it in warm water with a mild detergent, so that's what I'm doing. Next time you'll see them, they'll be on the drying rack. So here they heckin' are. Ah, worst traffic noise ever, but you live next to a road. Okay, so I was about to start doing some tidying in my room, but then the doorbell rang and my freaking internet thingy from Amazon has been delivered, and now I am very scared that I won't be able to make it work. Did the box or the Amazon listing or the anything actually tell you that you need this to install something that makes you able to use this thing? No. So yeah, I'll just have to kind of breathe in and relax my whole body about that and just try not to take it as a sign that this is just gonna, that I'm cursed and everything's gonna turn out bad when it comes to fixing this. Oh Lord Jesus, no. Wildest headlines about them, ask me anything. I literally like don't want to watch this. Like, it's gonna just destroy me. Like, will it be hilarious? Will it be just me looking at these two and just saying kiss, 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 kiss? Like, I don't know what it's gonna be, and I'm terrified. Little update, shorts drying overnight. So, hell yes, complete success, pretty much the exact color I wanted. Very proud of myself. Hey, hi, hello. So, I have the brilliant idea that I should have had, like, yesterday, possibly even the day before, which is actually physically taking my laptop to a tech shop. So I'm gonna take my laptop and my thingy in and see if he can get it to work. And honestly, I think that's my last hope before having to get a new computer. And can I afford to get a new computer? No. So yeah, we're relying on this guy a little bit. Hello, hello sir, I'm gonna meet you in a few minutes and I hope that you are a miracle worker. In the meantime, it is my turn to cook some dinner for tonight, so I think I'm going to do spaghetti bolognese with gluten-free pasta. Yeah, I'm gonna go do that, and hopefully by the time I'm finished and I've got it in the fridge to eat later, because it's still the day and then we'll eat it at dinner, I just want to do it early while I have the energy. Hopefully when I'm at the opposite end of making dinner, I'm gonna get a call or a text from this guy saying that my computer's fixed. All right, y'all, I got the text from the guy, went to the computer shop, my laptop is fixed. I also think it's really cute because in like, I don't know, like 80s and 90s movies that were, you know, maybe set these days, like, you know, there's a hacker and the spy operation. I feel like they have these kinds of things in their computers, like to make them look more technological and cool. But I have a cool attachment now, so I'm totally a hacker from a movie. So, yeah, fear me. Here he is. Don't think I can get focus on him because he's too small. But here is my thing that turns me into a hacker. He has saved my life.
Something else I've seen recently that is giving me tidying vibes is that Molly Roberts, the art witch, one of my absolute icons in life, recently posted a Patreon video where she was kind of overhauling everything in her studio and getting it together. And this is coming like straight after and in the middle of me doing a really big overhaul of my room and like getting rid of some stuff that I didn't need. I'll talk to you more about it later in this vlog. But basically I was seeing her do it and I was literally watching the video while I was tidying mine. So I was like, yay, like I just felt very correct with a capital C to be doing that. Except obviously my studio is too small and it has a bed in it. So one day I wish for a studio like hers. I guess it would be film on one side and then practical fine art on the other. And then maybe, would my writer's desk be in there too? I don't know. Big question. I love how I'm saying this as though I will ever, 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 ever be able to afford a place big enough to devote a room to a studio. Like, you've got to be kidding me. Anyway.
Alrighty guys, it's time to face the music. I need to change my sheet. Obviously, I have taken off the old one. This is just the regular Aduna that I now need to cover. But my room is so small that there's a bunch of stuff here on the bed that is there because I've got nowhere else to put it. So whenever I have to change my sheets, all of this stuff needs to go on the floor. So all of where my clothes just were and those things just were, they all have to go here for the bed to be clear. This will also be a good tour of things that are on my bed that probably shouldn't be. And then on the corner here, these are supposed to stay on the corner but they don't, is my collection of hats. There we have kind of this hat with a purple ribbon on it because the guy at the store that had it was really nice and I felt sorry for him so I bought it. And then that is my trilby, and then that one is my top hat that I got at age 17 or so to use for a Marlena Dietrich costume. So these guys need to get out of the way. Oh my god, I just found my Wednesday shirt, or one of them. I was wondering where this was. Now we have a giant unicorn plush head thing that my brother gave to me, and you put it on your head and then your eyes are here and you can walk around with it. And it's ridiculous, but because he gave it to me, I don't want to give it away, because that's just me. Here is my beautiful Paisley dog that I literally found on the side of the road in like 2021.
He found me by fate and I am keeping him for my children.
Here we've got some toys. Dartle the Grey with me since I was practically born, I think. Here he is, hi.
And now the ultimate thing that should not be on a bed but it is, my disco ball. Nowhere to put it, nowhere, completely nowhere, so here it is.
Hello darlings and welcome back to Friday. I'm now going to go into more of the kind of, I guess, artistic chores of different things that I need to get together, like sorting paper for some collage workshops that I have coming up, which I'm so excited and grateful to be doing, just by the way. So today I've got a box of things and I'm going to be sorting it into a pile of what I'm giving into the box in the workshop. And then the stuff that I'm keeping for myself will be in a little pile. Sorting, and you guys get to see a little peep into my vast collection of art papers and magazine bits and stuff like that. Okay, let's get ahead and do that. Yes, I'm still sick, but I'm not gonna die. So let's get started with the paper. So first up, we have this Laura Blythman Dreamscape wrapping paper book with this amazing collage illustration style. And I took out the sheets and cut them down into about A4 sizes, so that way they're more easily shared rather than one person taking the whole bunch of one print. I love this Italian nonna with her like pink phone in a Gucci ad. Here we have some girls at the Malala Yousafzai school. Just look at their amazing compassion. They're queens. Very vintage Florence from like 2010, which is crazy. Some cool ladies from the 20s in their cute hats. And then that photo is by my favorite photographer, Tim Walker. Horse from a market, old calligraphy book, amazing vintage wrapping paper from Sonia Ailis, insane collection of Easter egg and lolly foils, the chicken there being my favorite. This was a shop wrapper, but it just looked like this vintage kind of newspaper. That is a, and this, the unicorns are illustrations from childhood books. Same here with Winnie the Pooh and Angelina Ballerina. Like, they're just so beautiful, I didn't want to give the book away. This is an illustration, I think, of New York, and I just love how graphic it is. That is from a girl's annual from the 50s. This is an amazing ballet book with these illustrations. Super cool napkin there. Another Tim Walker photo. That is Tavi Gevinson's mum weaving, and then the bell jar. Sparkly shoe, because I had these exact ones. More cutouts from a childhood book. This is by Sonia Ailis from Rookie Mag. That I think is from a restaurant, and it's amazing. That come with a vase I had, a giant candy cake. There is some petrol paper. I have made the DIY of that you guys have seen. Studio Ghibli origami, the best. QVB brochure, some flowers from my flower book, some Victorian scraps, some sheets on cakes. Art Nouveau flappers there. She liked to stir things up. This is some stuff I cut out for the music video that I did for Boy in Bucket. And on cue is the house from their album cover. Birdie Beetle, legendary Australian candy. And then, yay, found this little mirror. There I am. Haha. Amazing wrapping paper, students protest, goes without saying, super cool, like, twins, and then Alice in Wonderland, Australian Ballet, was that dancer, and then these are from a sticker book that I have, shaving cream, marbled paper, origami paper, Russian money. More cool, I love the name on that plane, and then that glorious photo of that woman staring at the other's boobs. There is a Halloween witch that I found, a candy wrapper, love hearts, my favorite. This gorgeous card from my dear friend Laura, that is from Rookie by Elle Hardwick. That, completely forgot, zombie chews, candy, dip dab. More candy wrappers, love hearts, very bougie yellow one there, and this one that makes me think of Wes Anderson. Here's some stuff from a really quirky book that I have about like photography. That's Whitner's Old Tissue Paper. Women and Inquiry cover, which makes me laugh so much. Lunig, the legendary Australian illustrator. Trumpet paper. Peacock paper. More petrol paper. I think this is my favorite sheet that I've made. I love those folk art kind of cards. This is a plastic bag from 2006 from a Parisian shop my family went to. Kite paper, favorite ever. These are some collage kits by Frankie Magazine, and I haven't cut them out much yet. All right, I hope you enjoyed that little look into a little bit of my paper collection. That was actually so fun going through it all and talking to you guys about it. And like, maybe I could make a series of me going through my papers, because I have so many boxes and so many things I need to organize. And I would just love to kind of show you what I've been collecting all of these years, because all of it's very dear to me and I've spent money and time and organizing and keeping it. So we might do that. That could be a video that's coming up. I have like figured out a way of organizing that I think will completely transform like what I do and how I store my paper. Basically, this section here is now organized into paper and whatever else for other people. So this goes into my collage workshops. Because I've got so much good quality paper, I want to create and sell sort of collage kits and junk journals. Like, I would just be kind of mad not to do that when I have all of this really beautiful, high quality stuff that I've collected over so many years. But then over here with these folders and books, and then that one, that one, that one, and then there's a box under my bed, but that's taken care of as well. Now it's actually going to be a clear spot where my artistic medium potential stuff, my artistic materials ends. It's there, and I don't have to go checking all over here the way maybe I used to in case I want something. Everything I want, I've gone through it and it's all over there. And all the stuff that I'm going to use in a different way is over here. Alrighty, darlings, the paper storage revolution after the sorting has occurred, and I'm very proud of myself. I think I'm going to spend the rest of this afternoon, or Friday afternoon, just doing some writing. I've got some stuff that I want to do, I think there are a few cover letters and applications to various things that I want to go and check, because I check everything 5 million times before I send it. But then also I want to work on some creative stuff, like the story that I mentioned earlier in this week, and just kind of wherever my brain wants to go, because in an interview, Greta Gerwig said, follow what's alive in relation to like creativity and writing and things. So like whenever I'm looking to do something, like whether it's like physically craft in my room, or like screenplays or writing or video making or whatever, follow what's alive. So I'm gonna sit here, I'm gonna do some writing, and I'm gonna follow what's alive. So thank you for hanging out with me this week. I'm gonna end this vlog here.
I hope that seeing me be productive was inspiring, and I hope that seeing some of my paper collection and all the crazy different things and sources that are in it inspires you to start yours. And, you know, maybe I've found a new genre type of video for myself, which is showing off my paper collection and just, you know, buried treasure, etc. So anyway, subscribe if you want more of my witchy creative chaos. Comment down below if you found something interesting in this video, anything you want to say. You know I love talking to you guys. Give it a like, and remember, I love you. Keep going.